Without any more hesitation, please make sure you have a pen or a pencil and something to write on, because you've got a lot of information. Or maybe hope that your friend next to you will let you take a picture of it once you get in their session. All right, in case you did not know, you graduate in 38 days.
Yes.
So, that was lame. You graduate in 38 days.
Woo!
Much better. So, we have all kinds of information to give you guys. The first one is the Senior Awards Night. This is going to be on May 7th at 7:30. If you are getting an award, you will receive an invitation for this. So just have a heads up. Those are going out. That's at Lakewood Baptist. So then we have some friends who are planning the baccalaureate service. They're going to come up and talk about that really quick.
Hey everybody, so the baccalaureate service is May 6th, it's a Sunday, and it's at St. Paul United Methodist Church, which is off of the square, and the baccalaureate service is just a nice little church service. There's going to be a guest speaker, and afterwards there's light refreshments served by Key Club, and it starts at 1:30 p.m., but seniors need to show up at 1 p.m. to be ready to line up, because you do wear your cap and gown and wear business casual clothing, because there's a lot of photo opportunities there. It's just a nice little service to honor everything that we've done.
Thank you, Leah. All right, we have a couple messages from our yearbook staff.
Distribution day is May 16th, and the senior cookout is also that day.
The theme is senior cookout.
We need the following items right here.
Mark, can you advance that for me real quick? Thank you. All right, so the yearbook day is May 16th. That is your last day for seniors. There's a times for the senior cookout from 11:10 to 2:40. They're asking you guys to wear your college gear, your career stuff, you're going to military, sport insurance, all that kind of stuff. You can have hats and sunglasses for outside. So keep that in mind. And there's going to be an ice cream truck, so bring some cash for that. And then any kind of outdoor games, like you have football, that kind of stuff. Also, they're doing the senior walkout again this year. So bring your cap and gown with you that day. And so you guys will walk out through the halls. You are dismissed once the walkout occurs. If you still need to buy a yearbook, you can pay $75 cash or check until the end of this month. And then in May, it's $80 cash only. So see Ms. Barnett if you have questions. And understand that once it sells out, it sells out. So do that quickly if you're not bought one yet.
All right. Those of you who are college bound, you have to send a final transcript to the college you choose to go to, because they need proof that you've graduated. We'll send that for you, but we need you to fill out a form telling us what your choice is. So we have forms in the counselor's office. I have some here today if you want to grab some. We just definitely need you to turn that in by your last day, May 16th. College bound also. Information about HOPE if you're staying in Georgia. You can check your final eligibility in the summer. Should be towards the end of June or early July. You just have to log on to Georgia Futures, and hopefully you all still know how to get into your account and to see what that final GPA is. Just remember, that GPA is an academic GPA, so when we give you a copy of your last transcript at graduation, that is your overall GPA with every class you've ever taken included. The academic GPA is just your academic and foreign language classes. red letters. That's something we've been doing traditionally every year, where your friends and family can send congratulations to you, and we give it to you right after practice at graduation. We are mailing this week, so you should really get it any day now, a letter home that has information about all the graduation details and information about red letters. So make sure your family sees that so they can participate and send those congratulation cards, letters to you. Tickets. I know this is a hot item. Each senior will get 7 tickets this year, and if you participate and commit to the C, you will get 8. Mr. Scobman is going to be who gives you the tickets at the end of the year, and there's a process for doing that that we'll go through now. Just know he does not have any extra tickets. Okay, so if you need extra tickets, you have to ask your classmates. Not everybody may need all of their tickets, so they can then share tickets with you. Just make sure do not sell these tickets, do not buy these tickets. These are given to us free. Do the right thing and share if you don't need them. The pink sheet, as we'll show you an example of in a minute, there's lots of items to take care of and all the instructions are there. But we just want you to know, as you're taking care of these things, you cannot interrupt classes for your teachers or Mr. Scobman, because they still have to teach through the end of the year. So it's very important to do this when you're in class, during class, before school, after school, or some teachers will put signs on their door when they're available to do that. And going back to the tickets, again, every person, whether they're 90 or 2 months, has to have a ticket for graduation. That's just rules of the facility. So yes, a baby that's gonna sit in someone's lap does need to get a ticket. Pink sheet. Okay, we're gonna chime in together on this. This is the part that all of your teachers sign, okay? So they're all they're signing is that whether you passed or failed, okay? And that's all 7 teachers. Now, for anybody who's taking college classes, I'll be glad to sign for those. Anybody who's doing honors mentorship, I'll be glad to sign for that as well. But every teacher who's on this campus does need to sign these for you in their slot.
And guys, you might have some of your teachers who will tell you they will not sign until like Tuesday or Wednesday. And so just respect that, especially if you are on the borderline of failing. If they sign it, it has to be based off of your current stuff, not hoping that you're going to turn something in, you know, about Wednesday or whatever. So just be aware of that.
And then there's a few other folks that need to sign as well. Ms. Gibson for the Media Center, you have to be cleared for textbooks. I'll sign, but I need to sign after all your teachers do, okay? Because it's just another way that I can double check that you've passed everything. So kind of get me at the end. Ms. Rudd will sign for Justin's to make sure that you've taken care of everything that you've ordered and picked up all of your good stuff. And we need your signature and a parent's signature. And these are the general rules. Make sure that you take care of your debts, okay? Now, that could be anything from a book, to a teacher, the Media Center, calculator, or fees from some activity that you've done throughout high school. Everything must be taken care of or you will not get your tickets, might not even be allowed to walk at graduation. Okay, so really make sure you take care of all your debts. Obviously, you've got to make sure your information is at the top of this form. We usually try to put a name label there to help a little bit with that. We talked about the signatures, going to Mr. Scobman, and we'll give you his times as well. If you lose this, there are replacements in the Media Center, but you've got to pay $5. Okay, so keep up with it. It is going to be pink, so it's not hard to spot, but do make sure that you keep up with it.
Guys, this finish, that final pink sheet, once it's all filled out, that's what you give to Mr. Scobman, and then he will give you the tickets in exchange. With the media center stuff, it doesn't matter, guys, if it was a book you lost from Chesapeake Academy. Like, that stays on your account and follows you. You have to pay for that in order for us to clear it. So that's what it's talking about, the media center stuff. So if you know you have an outstanding fine, go ahead and get that taken care of before there's a long line, you know, those last couple of days. All right, you can go ahead and do that again.
And for the tickets, Mr. Skoglund goes ahead and separates stacks for each graduate. So your tickets aren't going to be given away. So don't worry about that. There's enough for everybody in the amount that you should get, 7 or 8. Just got to make sure to take care of your stuff before he will give those to you. Okay. At graduation, I know people like to give you flowers, balloons, all those kind of things. They cannot bring that into the auditorium area, so they will need to leave that outside the facility and give that to you afterwards, okay?
And I think last year they can bring it in the building at home.
Right, and so they will stop anyone from bringing that in, so just so you know that ahead of time to tell your parents. Also, there can be no noisemakers inside, and they do watch for that as well, so no air horns, cowbells, anything like that. And here's the big day information. Saturday, May 26th, the graduation time is 7 p.m., but we have to practice for that. So you guys will need to be there at 4 so we can practice, and you must attend, okay, in order to walk. Come prepared with your cap and gown in hand, dress, because there's not time to leave in between practice and the graduation ceremony. There's really just not time. So you want to eat before you come, okay? And then you can eat afterwards. But there's just not time to do that in the middle of the ceremony. At the end, it's very important, we'll tell you this now, we'll tell you this at practice, you have to pick up your diploma after the ceremony's over. Okay, the room that we gather in is where we come back to after graduation, and you go directly to your advisement teacher, and you'll see we'll have names scattered about the room. Go directly to them, and you have an envelope that has your diploma and a copy of your last transcript. Okay, so remember, you have to do that, because you'd be surprised when we come back to school with about 10 or 12 diplomas each year. So don't let that be you. Make sure you pick up your envelope before you leave. You can purchase pictures at graduation. Katie Studios will be there to film you or take a picture of you as you walk across the stage and shake Ms. Gerard's hand. And so they'll have a table out in front where you can buy those pictures if you would like. And this I mentioned a few minutes ago, but there is a letter coming in the mail to each of you this week that has all the specifics of graduation. And if you need a translated copy, we have those in the counselor's office. Just come and we'll be glad to give you a copy of those. All the information on there about appropriate clothing, dates, times, all of that stuff is there. So please read through that carefully. Have your family read through that carefully.
Let's talk about some clothes.
Everybody always asks this. So, it's pretty easy. Appropriate stuff, ladies, you can wear a dress, skirt, nice pants, any color is fine. You don't have to wear white, okay? You do need to have appropriate shoes, so no sneakers, no flip-flops. Ladies, let me tell you now, you have several steps. You have to go up and down. Don't come in 6-inch heels, all right? Don't do it. We always take bets every year as how long somebody's gonna fall. It's gonna be awesome. All right, gentlemen, you do need to wear dark or khaki pants. Collared shirt, preferably a white one, all right? And a tie with dress shoes, no sneakers or flip-flops or that kind of stuff, all right? So that's your attire. Does anybody, questions, let's talk about this. If you have questions for the greater good, meaning like it applies to everybody, or if you have something specific to you, you can come ask us in a second. Yes?
All right, so if you don't follow the dress code,
you don't walk. Yes? You wear boots? As long as they're nice looking boots. Polish them up, shine them up, all that kind of stuff. Yes? I cannot hear you. Yes?
So, like, what type of dress?
Yeah, no Converse. It's on the no-fly list. Yes.
How do you know if you have a fine? Like, should you go ask the media center?
Yes. What we will do is we print these senior fine sheets that'll have, like, it's a big page, and it shows, like, if you have any stuff that's still checked out to you, like calculators and all. Or you can come by and you can ask, and we'll scan badges or put in your student ID number and let you know.
Okay.
Yes.
Also check with your sponsors of activities you participated in to make sure you're clear there, too.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Is throwing your cap at graduation allowed?
Yeah. You realize you have to come back and find it. We're not going to find it.
Okay.
And I'll also make sure you have
on the floor, so just realize you risk losing your
castle. So you can, though.
Yes.
Can we decorate our caps?
No. Listen, does anybody else have questions? Yes. Somebody asked about the cap decoration. This is coming from Ms. Gerard. She said no, absolutely not. All right? And that is one of those things, again, you do it, you cannot wear that cap. Like, you'll have to find another one. We don't have extra as soon as you buy another one. All right, so just so you have a heads up. Questions? Anything else? All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your time. You guys have a good day.